This is Jay Arthur, author of the QI Macros. Let's talk about how to format charts in Excel once you've drawn them. There are two main types of charts you're going to create: time series charts like this one, and category charts, in this case a column chart. And so if you go in and grab some data, here you can see we have some data, and click on Insert, you can choose your chart, but Excel will recommend the chart for you. You'll recognize that that's a time series chart. Here you can see we've drawn all of that. Now, once you have the chart, grid lines are often chart junk. You might want to add axis labels. If you click on this little plus element over here, we can add axis titles and get rid of the grid lines. So that's a pretty quick way to go. You can add a legend, but it's not going to tell you anything. And once you have titles here, what you want to do is we might want to come in and say, you know, this was whatever year it is, 2022. And down here we might say, this might be number of mistakes or errors or something. All right, so there's our time series chart. Now if we select this data over here, which is more category oriented, say Insert and ask Excel, it will tell you that's a bar chart, right? So we'll click on OK, and here you can see we've done that, and we can again add that and add axis labels, get rid of the grid lines, and we have to relabel some things. Now, these are all fine and well and good, but sometimes you might need a smarter chart, right? You can see there's different things going on here. The best chart for this kind of data would probably be a Pareto chart. And in the QI macros, you can draw a Pareto chart. Just we add a pull down onto Excel's menu, select that data with your mouse, click on the button, and you'll get our labeled Pareto chart. Bent is the biggest, cuts the most, and then folded categories. So the first two are two-thirds of our type of error. Now we could also take our time series chart. This data could also be shown using what's called a run chart. And so this will come up with our median and show the chart. Or we could take that data and we could also show that as a control chart. And the control chart wizard will pick the right chart for you. In this case, a C chart, which shows that on average we have 4.8 mistakes per month, and there's some variability in here, and there's no special causes because none of these points are red. That's a little bit about formatting charts, and even here if you click on this, you'll see you can change designs, you can change formats, you can do things about how it fills things, outlines things. If you come up here, you can click on this and say I want to look at the time series data, and maybe I want to format that, and you can then come up and say how do I want to do this, and I might want to change the color of the line. There's a lot of things you can do in Microsoft Excel to change it, because once you click on a chart, you get the chart tools. All right, I'd encourage you to go ahead and do that. And if you want to change something like the chart title, you can change what kind of text we're using. So there's all kinds of options to make your chart prettier once you've done this. All right, so that's how you format charts in Microsoft Excel. Just start playing with it. And even in here, if you want to, you can simply right click on something like the axis, and you can say format axis, and it'll go out and bring up your axis titles. So maybe I want a minimum of, let's say, 1. You can change that angle. All right, so I just want you to get this idea that everything can be adjusted in a chart in Microsoft Excel. Are you still using line, bar, and pie charts from the last century? You might want to consider control charts, Pareto charts, and histograms. Smart charts for the 21st century.